Thank you, Mr. President. As Israeli civilians in the north watched with horror while their brothers and sisters in the south were tortured, raped, beheaded, and kidnapped by Hamas terrorists, they fled to bomb shelters as Hezbollah rained down missiles in a show of solidarity, that's how they call it, with these butchers, with these savages. Irit Efrati has lived in Kibbutz Dan in the north since her birth. She has only ever had to flee her home one other time, as a seven-year-old in our War of Independence in 1948. Now, aged 83, she again finds herself as a refugee in the city of Haifa. For nearly a year, Irit has struggled to maintain her sanity, confined to a small room and far from the life and home she built over a lifetime. This is not a unique story. Irit joins tens of thousands of Israelis now living in cramped temporary housing, praying for the day she will return to the only place she has ever called home. Since October 8, almost 9,000 rockets, along with hundreds of anti-tank missiles, have been launched at our civilians, targeting their homes, families, and the state. Since October 8, 70,000 civilians have been forced to flee their homes. They have been made refugees within their own country. They do not know when they will be able to return home, restart their lives, or when their children can go back to their schools. Since October 8, terrorists and their relentless attacks have injured more than 370 Israelis and murdered 49, including 12 Israeli Druze children who were playing soccer. And now, I sit here again to defend Israel's actions, as if any other country in our situation would behave differently, would chart any different course, and would not act in the defense of their people. No nation, you know, be honest, no nation would sit idly by as its citizens are attacked. Over the past week, Israel has been conducting precise strikes in Lebanon against Hezbollah's command centers, launching sites, missile and weapon stores, and their leadership. On September 20th, we targeted Hezbollah terrorist leaders during a meeting where they were planning a second October 7th. Hezbollah has made it clear, given the chance, they would storm our borders, infiltrate our communities, murder, rape, and take hostages back to their dens of horror. Yet the Security Council, the Secretary General, some UN officials, and even UNIFIL commanders can barely bring themselves to mention Hezbollah. Listen to all the statements, like you cannot mention this word. Hezbollah, the internationally designated terrorist organization that began this conflict and acts in constant violation of UN Security Council resolutions. For years, we have been clear, we fully support Resolution 1701, like the Prime Minister just mentioned. We support the resolution, and we support its complete implementation. For years, we have sounded the alarm over Hezbollah's blatant violations. For years, we have provided undeniable evidence of their military buildup, yet our warnings have been ignored. The time for half measures is over. Resolution 1701 must be enforced in full, without delay. And I remind you, it says that the Lebanese army will be on the border with Israel, not Hezbollah. Perhaps some of you have forgotten how this started and why we must defend ourselves, but we have not. And I make this declaration here today to remove any doubt. Never again will the Jewish people hide from the monsters whose purpose in life is to murder Jews. Never again will we provide the benefit of the doubt to those who declare their intention to murder Jews. When they tell us and show us who they are, we will believe them. We will take all necessary steps within our rights and in accordance with international law to neutralize that threat. Israel does not seek a full-scale war. We have made our desire for peace clear to all those who are not blinded by hatred and political agendas. However, Israel is under attack. In the last 24 hours, northern and central Israel have faced a new wave of relentless attacks, with over 150 rockets launched deep into Israeli territory, into areas that are home to 1.5 million Israelis. These strikes have injured civilians and destroyed homes in communities like Tzfat and Rosh Pina. This morning, Hezbollah escalated their aggression, launching a surface-to-surface missile towards Tel Aviv. At the same time, Iran's other proxy, the Islamic Resistance in Iraq, one of many in the Middle East, has claimed responsibility for UAV and cruise missile attack on our northern and eastern regions. Yet, many continue to remain silent on Hezbollah's crimes, further emboldening Iran's terror proxies to continue their attacks. They are not discriminating based on race or creed. Nazareth, an important northern Israeli city with a population of 70% Muslim and 30% Christian, the hometown of Jesus himself, was showered with rockets just a few nights ago. Not only does Hezbollah target civilians, but they also continue to hide behind them. Israel has uncovered clear evidence that Hezbollah is using civilian homes as storage and launch sites for their missiles. They are homes where families live. They use the basement, they use the rooftop to put the rockets, and they force people to stay in the houses. These are homes where children sleep. They exploit the very people they claim to represent, putting both Israeli and Lebanese civilians in the line of fire. Worse still, they fire from positions near UNIFIL posts, recklessly endangering peacekeepers from across the world. This is not just a war against Israel. It is a war against humanity, waged by Iran's proxies. They hold the people of Lebanon hostage. We know that. Using their homes as shields for their rockets, pushing the entire region to the brink of destruction. We cannot accept these conditions. We will not let Iran's terrorist proxies dictate how Israelis can live their lives. We will not let our north become a war zone. Mr. President, every representative here knows which entity is behind it, orchestrating this situation. It is the regime that has placed a countdown clock in the center of their capital, counting the days until our destruction. I haven't been to Tehran, but if you'll go there, you will see that clock ticking. The Islamic regime of Iran is the driving force behind the rockets that have been launched at our communities for almost a year, the driving force behind Hezbollah's aggression, and the driving force behind the instability sweeping our region. At the head of the terrorist snake, Iran has spread its venom against innocent Israeli civilians, from the Houthis in Yemen attempting to strangle global trade, to Hezbollah's rocket barrage, from Hamas's practice of rape and kidnapping, to the Shia militias in Syria and Iraq targeting Western personnel. We all know the Ayatollah stands behind it all. Every missile fired by Hezbollah, every drone launched by Iranian proxies, every act of terror on foreign soil traces back to one source, the Islamic regime of Iran. It is the spider at the center of this web of violence, and we have to fight this web of violence. There can be no peace in the region until we dismantle this threat. Esteemed colleagues, there is a clear path of action for this Council if it truly wishes to avoid escalation. Demand the immediate implementation of Resolution 1701. Designate Hezbollah and the Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps as a terrorist organization. And finally, stop casting blame on the side defending its citizens. Instead, find the courage to once and for all name and condemn the true aggressor responsible for igniting this cycle of violence. I thank you, Mr. President.